Hello, and welcome back to episode 3 and the Cicerose Strait here in Blue Ocean. We are exploring the Aegean Sea, looking for some secrets. Specifically, I'd like to check out what we were looking at last episode, which was the Arctos, basically the sinking of the Arctos, which is an ancient ship from Greece. And we found a few things near the Undine last time as well. And I want to explore more about it. So, let's get to it. Ooh. So, great whites, maybe? A lot of great whites? That's unnerving. Good thing we've got this not so lethal... we'll call it taser. Medical taser. So do you have free reign, more so? You don't have to stay within a certain range of the ship, right? Like, you can just go about wherever you see fit? Because I don't see a range of places that you can't go. Which is pretty nice. There's a reef shark, I believe? A white tip? Yeah, white tip reef shark. Oops. Huh. Ooh. Oh no, look over there. It's a great white shark. Great white sharks are just as ferocious as tiger sharks. And this one seems really mad for some reason. You can use your can you use your pulsar to calm it down? If you take care of this guy for us, we can take our time searching the ship. Danger. Oh shit, it looks angry. Woo. Ha. Gotcha. Oh no, did it hit me? It did. Oh, the batteries. We've gotta wait. Okay. I think when it hits you, it takes some of your oxygen too, right? Okay, we need to check our pulsar. Cool, we've got some charge on it. Where is it? Oh man. Not good. Okay, let's try to loop around and maybe we can get out of sight and turn to find it. I found all the things. What is this? Ooh, hi. It's a bicolor goby, Blenny. Yeah, bicolor Blenny. They're so cute. Okay, back to the danger shark over here. The danger shark, if I could find it, the fact that it's just, oh, there it is. It's got a really wide range. Did it hit me again? Jeez, yeah, it does take the your oxygen when it hits. I wonder if we can hit it at it from a distance. I would imagine so. Ooh. Okay. It's a lot more dangerous. So I think we should let it charge and then try to attack it from a distance. Because... getting closer is not really working out for us. Well, for me. Hmm. Is it? I don't understand. Is the pulsar not hitting it? It was. So whatever, for whatever reason, my strikes before were not hitting it. There we go. Jeez. Took a lot of focus. The great white swam off. Now we can relax and check out on our search. Use the multi-sensor. See if there's anything else in this area. Ooh, I think I saw something over here before we took out the shark. Yeah, here it is. I'm sure we'll be able to find other things as well, but this one's pretty obvious to me. No multi-sensor needed. Ooh, a new bracelet, Triton bracelet. Wow. What's this? It looks like an old bracelet with something carved in it. Hey, look. Isn't this some kind of map? It looks like a town surrounded by whirlpools, doesn't it? Whirlpools? Does that mean the Siceros Undines? Siceros Undines are found mainly in the waters to the southwest. Why don't you investigate that area? Yeah, we don't have much else in the way of leads, so why don't we look in the southwest of the Siceros Strait? What if there's. Yeah, like, there's totally other things down here we can check out. Here we are. Oh, cute. More of the gobies and pistol shrimp. Cloudy cat shark. Those are kind of cute, actually. Ooh, and a coin. Boots coin. Slug. Strigate chromodorus. It's a cute little sea slug. Let's see if we can actually go further up and around the ship. Can we go in? Yeah, too small. That would have been pretty neat, though. More perch. All right, let's check the map. Oh, is this tuna? Tuna! Looks like tuna. Come back. They're all in unison. I love that. Atlantic bluefin tuna. Oh, look at the rays around this wreck, too. Trevallies. Giant trevally. Big eye trevallies. And, ooh, octopi? Octopi. Common octopus. This one too? Yeah. Manta ray. Looks like some type of eel down here as well. European conger eel. Ooh, conger eels were pretty popular. Fairly popular in smaller towns during the medieval era as a stable source of sustenance. Mercury coin is. I feel like this slug looks different. It is different. Spotted white sea slug, they're so pretty. I don't know if it's just me being weird, but I think they're really cute. I also think the sea hares that are, they look like little slug snow bunnies, they're really adorable. Okay, let's go. Ooh, so I guess since we're here, let's check out the little bit that's left over on the map over here. If anything, just so we can explore and uncover it on the map. Ooh, another coin. I love coins. Cygnus coin. And you are Threadfin butterfly fish. I have seen these in person. They're not super, super vibrant, but they're very pretty and elegant. Huh? What? I think that means we need to use a sensor. That sound is meant for telling us something, but I'm not sure what that. I'm not sure. Oh, it means I'm running out of air. You're almost out of air. Return to the boat. Okay. Yeah. Got it. Don't need to drown. I was like, I know that means something. But what does it mean? It means go up. It's time to go up for air. All right, let's go back down. It said to start, I guess we have to start here. And then just go down where we were. That's kind of lame. You can't move the boat like you could in EO1. All of the mahi. Okay, let's make it pertinent to where we go, to where this, the marked place on the map so we can further the story. And see things, uncover things, really. Tell myself I need to focus. Do not get sidetracked. There's just so much to see. I know I'm not the only one who struggles with this. There's so much to see. Oh, but there's an Undine here. Took another look at the sea chart. Southwest Cicero Strait is completely sealed off by the five Cicero's Undines. There is no way to proceed, and it is a total impasse. Oh, that's just great. What do we do now? I guess we could show Nancy our finds. Yeah, that lapis lazuli bracelet. It was some kind of ancient writing engraved on it. Maybe Nancy can tell us what it means. What should we do? Head back to the Nine Ball Island for now? Yeah, probably should. Head back, see what she thinks. And maybe we'll find out more information on it. And or on the shipwreck, the Arctos. Isn't... Isn't that on like a completely part of different... It is on... Nine Bell Highlands on a different part of the world. Guess we'll just come back when we need to. Interesting. That's quite a flight just to, you know, come back. This small island is only 100 feet in diameter, surrounded by miles and miles of coral reef. That sounds beautiful. Beautiful. Call Nancy? Yes, sir. Let's see what she has to tell us. Here I am, like a bolt in the blue. What can I do for you? You want me to look at something for you? You showed Nancy the Triton bracelet. Ah, another old artifact. This is lapis lazuli and very, very old. And carved on it, we have... Oh, wow. This is written in Linear B. Linear B is a script that was used by the Mycenaeans who lived in the islands of the Aegean Sea. It's over 3,500 years old and predating even the Greek alphabet. This is an extremely rare find. Well, Linear B is known... is a known alphabet, and the words themselves are Greek. So the internet should solve most of our problems. Just hold on there a minute. I've deciphered the text. Fishermen of Triton Village of the Iluros Cape, may heed if you value your life. Even whirring waters fear the night. Sail when all is quiet and calm twilight. Looks like some kind of warning, written in ancient fishermen. The calm twilight must be that night, after the sun sets. Oh, that reminds me. Jean-Eric, you've asked me to get some night diving gear. I have it for you right here. You've already paid me for it, so here you go. Yay, new equipment. And here's a free gift. Consider it an apology for the long wait. An underwater pen. Man, that thing is the bane of my existence. That pen. Ugh, that pen. Oh, and if you find anything interesting with your multi-sensor, let me know. I'll appraise it for you. For a small fee, of course. I guess we can appraise some stuff. Or not. Alright. Thanks a bunch. If you need anything else, just call. Now that I have the night diving gear, we can go diving anytime we want. How about we head back to Cicero Strait and do what the bracelet says? You do get situations where whirlpools appear and disappear over time, so it's totally believable that the whirlpool would disappear at night. So we're gonna fly across, you know, back across the world. Got it. I don't want the album. Whoops. I know, we put pictures here. Bum, 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 bum. All right, back to Greece. We've got to find this place before that guy does. Gigi? Is that what he wanted us to call him, Gigi? All right, let me know. Summarize what we've known so far. The legendary Valka Castle is said to be somewhere in the Cicero Strait. However, despite its best efforts of many who have looked, it has never been found. We decided to search for clues instead of for the castle itself. And we found that the whirlpools may disappear at night. The whirlpools are active in the southwest Cicero Strait, Triton Village, which was carved on the bracelet we found, which sank in that exact area. Fortunately, we have the equipment needed for night diving, so we can concentrate on their strait, the southwest of Cicero's. That's it, I think. Do you want me to go through it again? No, thank you. We've got it. Now all we need is to go wait for nightfall and then start diving. You can advance time by selecting rest while aboard the boat. Easy. Till midnight? That's pretty late. No? Do we have a later dive? Sunset. That'll give us more time. Alright. Yay, we can finally dive in a new area. More sharks. All right. Back in the street. Oh yeah, I almost forgot. I've adjusted the output on your multisensor so you can use it for salvaging. It should pick up any items buried in the C4 now. Give it a try, you'll never know what you might find. You can now use the multisensor to hunt for buried treasure items. Nancy will identify and appraise any items. Yeah, we know. For a small fee, right? For a small fee. I guess that wasn't an item we could use to pick up. Another coin! Coma Beresines coin. Ooh, I wonder if I have this shark. I don't think I do. Will it let me get super close? Sand tiger. Oof, at least he's not angry. I can't remember if we actually visited this one. I see a lot of the same species, so probably. But still pretty neat to see at night. Megre. Someone please. Current is too strong. Oh, we're at the edge of the map. That makes sense. So we didn't come this far before. Ooh. Peacock. I think these are peacock fish? Parrotfish. Bicolor parrotfish. There we go. Peacock. The colors made me think of a peacock. Wow, the oxygen drops pretty quick. In EO1, I feel like it was barely noticeable. Like, I didn't ever have to worry about my oxygen. Wreck of the Blood Lotus. Wow. I think we already... Yeah, lined sturgeon fish. Golden rock eye. I know I haven't seen you. In this game, at least. John Dory? Yeah. John Dory. John Dory here. Huh. Ooh. Where'd it go? I wonder if we have to use the sensor to find that one. It seems like it, but how do I get things out of the sand? Whoa. I know it mentioned we could, but pressing the A button is not doing it. Oh, duh. Got it. Ooh. Too big to fit in our bag. How do we come back for it? I don't want to leave it here. That's lame. We can't take it up. I'm assuming there's some type of bag upgrade, I would hope. So I really want to take the stuff we find up. Ooh, whiptail sharks. Triton Village ruins, the Cicero Strait. So these are the Triton Village ruins. They were hidden in the Cicero's by the Cicero's Undines. Based on historical records, these ruins don't seem to have any direct connection with Valka Castle. But we can't be sure until we look around. Let's explore for clues. Let's look. Ooh. Oh. More John Dory's, but did find something. An olive flounder? Hey, some young olive flounders. Don't you think they're just lovely? Huh? You think they might be right eye flounders? There's a way to tell large tooth flounders apart from right eye flounders. Do you know it? Which way do their faces look? The large tooth left and the right eye to the right. Wait, right tooth eye and left. Oh, I forget. I'm all confused. Yeah, it's kind of hard to tell, especially when it moves around like that. We are in the treasure hunt kind of mood. Oh, there's something. Oh. Oh. Ooh, a ring? Yes, salvage it. It looks like there's five things in this area. I think the red means we're close. This is fun. Oh, an ingot. Too big to fit in the bag. Dang. I'm assuming there's some stuff to kind of trick you to finding the other things. So, like the things that are too big won't. You just can't accept, so you have to look for something else. It's just something to trigger the multi-sensor, is my guess. Small box. Okay. Another trap. Treasure trap. I think we checked on this one. Let's look again. Ooh. Small bottle, okay. If Legend of Zelda has taught me anything, is that there's usually something special in small capped bottles like that. Uh-oh. Hey, there's somebody else here. It's Juji. What? I don't believe it. L&L Diving Service? Gaston Gray? What are you doing here? Hey, I thought I told you to call me Gigi. Fancy meeting you guys here, of all of the places in the Cicero Strait. Somehow, I don't think this is a coincidence. We must be following the same lead. Well, you'd better stay on your guard because right around here. What? Oh, look at the time. I better get going. He usually shows up right about now. Sorry, can't stick around. Gotta go. And if you know what's good for you, you'll probably want to get out of here too. Hey, wait! What's the matter down there? Did something happen? Grandpa, there's somebody down here already. And after saying that, he just took off. What was he so afraid of? I have a feeling we are gonna find out. Oh my Jesus. That is intense. People are friends, not food. People are friends, not food. Wow. It's the Meg. An angry Meg. Whoa, that is enormous great white shark. Is this what Gigi was worried about? The man-eating shark Thanatos? Oh no, he's coming this way. We don't have to do something. We have to do something about him. We don't even have to... We won't even be able to surface. Can you use the pulsar? Yeah, let me just endanger my life. Oh, no. Here it comes. Yep. Okay, we gotta attack it from further away, but I don't think we're gonna be able to. Huh. Oh, there it is. Gotta go back up. What are we going to do? If we don't think of something... Hide inside that old well? Great idea. The shark is too big. He'll never be able to fit. Let's do it. I ran out of air. You too. Come on. Over here. Ooh. Okay. We should be safe down here. It looks like we're going to be all right. I wonder if there's any chance that shark will give up and go home. Just to be on the safe side, I'll share my air with you. Aw, thank you. You know, this is really long and deep for a well. It looks like it goes on forever. This is really strange. It's like an underground passage down here. Wait a minute. What if this well is actually a secret entrance to the legendary Valka Castle? Come on, let's go deeper and find out. Let's find out. Oh. Stuff. Some teardrop butterflies. Some damsels. Maybe one of these. It's a different type of octopus. Oh no, I guess not. What about you? Chromis? Yeah. Oh, what are these? Orion coin. I like these. These look neat. It's a sea slug. It's hard to see because it blends in with the surroundings, but it's a luminescent sea slug. It's no surprise after hearing its name, but can you see itself glow? Watch closely. It should start glowing at any second now. Don't even think about poking it to make it glow. Why would I poke it? You don't know what things are, you don't touch it, especially in the ocean. That is a good way to die. All right, well. These more, yeah, parrotfish. Ooh, are these hammerheads? Look how cool those look from beneath. Wow. I like that. No, just in time. It's like an enormous tower. There are two corridors up here, one to the north and one to the east. I guess we're going through the north corridor. Maybe it was the right one? Ooh, Valka Castle, the Aegean Sea. Look at this place. It has to be the legendary Valka Castle. Grandpa, we found it. Can you hear me? I can, but just barely. The reception is terrible. But it sounds like you found what you were looking for. Nice work. My dad just might have been searching for this castle too. Could he be trying to tell us to find that treasure? The one that Gigi was talking about? Let's look inside the castle and see what we can find. Wait, this is your first confined space dive with an overhead environment. You're in a very old structure, so proceed with the utmost caution. You have the underwater pen, right? Use it to leave a marker in a place that's very easy to remember. That way, if you get lost, you should be able to find your way back to that point specifically. However, it's primarily a means of underwater communication. Well, anyway, let's test it by leaving a mark here. I'll leave the design up to you, just make sure it's something awesome. Okay. Make sure we know X-ish marks the spot. That's perfect. Oh look, the fish have gathered around the mark. This is called positive photoaxism. Some fish are attracted to the glowing fluorescence of an underwater pen. Isn't that fascinating? This is fun to use to attract certain fish. Photoaxism. What is this? Is this a catfish? Some subspecies of a catfish? A sea robin. Okay, I feel like I saw those in EO1, but they just look different. Oh, another slug! So cute. A yellow, a branch sea slug, but I like that it's yellow and bioluminescent. Let's see what's in this little corridor. The armory. I bet there's something special in here. Ooh, a grouper. Ooh, a coin. A chameleon coin. Look at these little jellies. There we go. Ooh. Turritopsis nutricula. Nutricula. I wonder if we use the multi-sensor. Aha! I had a feeling. Oh, this is the one for the multi-sensor. Oh, it's a book. Yes, let's salvage the book. Sunset Antheus. These are really pretty too. Actually, I don't think we got the grouper. Grouper in the armory. Long tooth, yep, yep. We've got it. Stop. There's a lion, a Luna lionfish here. Their long dorsal and pectoral fins are extremely venomous. It will be incredibly painful if you're stung by one of them. They won't actively attack you, but they're still very dangerous. It's better to stay away from them. Just stun them. A little flap flap. Blue spotted ribbon tail ray. I love them. They're so pretty in color. Okay. Nothing too crazy. Stay at a distance to get the encyclopedia reading, and we'll be off and around. Ooh, danger. Really? I didn't think I was that close. Guess I was. Are those blue spotted? I don't think they are. Yeah, red stingrays. Ooh! Cardinal fish and some chromis. See what the multi-sensor has to show us. Oh geez. I see that big ol' shark. Oh. There's a small hole in the door that someone small could get through. Are we small enough? We sure aren't. I wonder if it'll be like our partner, if we should whistle. Guess not. It was a cool thought, though. To have our partner kind of go through there, bust the door in so we could check it out. Gotta save the pancakes. Save all the sea pancakes. I wonder if this is just gonna say the door is locked too. About to be bothered by a big nope. Yep. Big nope. Oh, those fish are pretty. Don't really want to interact with this big old shark in here, though. The underwater gallery. I bet there's some pretty artwork, maybe? If it survived? Ooh. It's like a wrasse of some sort. You. Is it? A clown wrasse. See, look at me. All of my identification. Doing good work. Ooh. Jelly. I know that's a jelly. Don't know what kind. A mauve stinger. It's quite beautiful. But not beautiful from a distance. Let's leave it at that. Beautiful from a distance. I actually really like these tools in this version of the game, in the second version. The other ones I think were nice, but more so just had to use them to progress. These actually give depth to the game and make it feel more adventurous. It makes it feel more full, if that makes sense. And I really like that. Ooh, a coin. Venus coin. Who are you? So cute. A Harlequin sweet lip. Oh, these do look different. These look interesting from how they do as adults versus juveniles. More jelly. Peanut butter jellyfish, peanut butter jellyfish. Okay. Is this door open? It is. Ooh, the painting. Hey, look over there. There's some kind of weird map. Oh, Europa. Oh. Okeanos. Okeanos. The oceans around Europa. Can you hear me down there? It sounds like you found something quite unusual. It's a map of a circular Earth called... Oh, man. Anaximander's map of the world. Anaximander's map of the world. Anaxi who in the what now? It's one of the several world maps that ancient Greeks created. It depicts three large continents in a circular disk surrounded by a single ocean. Imagine what the ancient Greeks would think of modern-day globes. That map may be something from Prince Valka's private collection. Should take a picture of it. That'd be cool. But until then... Let's identify some of these fish. Long head hair tail and red cornet fish. Looks like there's some little guys over here. Samurai squirrel fish. Alright. No, don't want you. I want what is below you. More wrasse and jellies. Let's see if there's anything down here that's interesting. At least in this room. Oh. We're close. Ooh. Aw. We can't take it. Maybe we can take whatever this is? Ooh, okay. Too large to fit in your bag. Dang. We need a bag upgrade. We definitely need a bag upgrade. Ooh. Is this actually something we can take? Nope. I wonder how we're going to get into some of these areas that are either closed off or like that hole in the door. I wonder how we're gonna be able to get through that and see some of these other areas. Like, I'm assuming there's a way. Ooh. There they go. Well, it looks like that's all we can really see. We're starting to run out of air. So, I think it'd be a good time to return to the boat. Your diving level went up! It should. We were down there for a while. Oh my goodness, look how much we uncovered. We missed a lot. There's a lot we don't have access to yet. All right, well, I think that is where we're going to stop for episode 3 of Blue World. That was a lot of progress. Like, a lot of progress, but still yet there's so much about, you know, the castle that we haven't seen. And I wonder how we're going to be able to see it. I really feel like the dolphin or like your partner should be part of that journey where they can kind of swim through and give us options or some way to break the door down. I don't know, but that'll be interesting to figure out how we actually do it. And until next time, I can't wait to see you on episode 4 of Blue World. Thank you so much for joining me for episode 3. I'll see you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.